Hey guys, this is Gia Chu and you're watching The Sports TV.
What is up mga Lodi? Welcome back sa ating channel. Tara at panoorin natin ang 39 Kadayawan Invitational Basketball Tournament kung saan ay nagharap ang professional team na Rain or Shine kontra sa reigning UAAP champion Lasal. Sino kaya magwawagi isang professional team o ang UAAP champ? Tara at panoorin natin ang full game mga Lodi.
So here's our game at hand for tonight. This is the matchup once again between the UAP champion, the De La Salle Green Archers, and the Rain or Shine, the Last Two Painters, an Invitational Basketball Tournament. And of course, our referees, number 22, Sherwin Pineda, number 33, Mardi Montoya, and number 58, Brian Peclaro, and the opening tip controlled by the Rain or Shine, Last Two Painters. And just a few seconds gone by sa ating first quarter, and we have a whistle. I believe there's an issue. Let's see. So looks like it was whistled by one of our referees. That's Mardi Montoya. Looks like the issue has been addressed. Tingnan natin. So there's a brief stoppage here. Ito sa loob. 17 seconds. So there was a problem with the shot clock, so it should be 17 seconds on the shot clock. Mm-hmm. Looks like it's not much. So inaayos pa yung, we're hoping na inaayusin ng shot clock sa ating staff and officials dito sa USAP Gymnasium. There's the look of Gabe Norwood. And there's the bench of LaSalle. Now standing up, so hoping that they will be able to score the first bucket in a few moments' time. Here comes Andre Caracut, the former LaSallian, Nick DeMusis. Tinamaan lang sa side ng backboard. And here comes, yung sinabi mo ni Jonar Clarito.
Right, right. Kahit hindi ganun kaganda tingnan yung tira, but it's still 2 points, ano?
Oh, alright. It's still 2 points, indeed.
At the end of the day, yun yung goal natin eh.
Nagahanap ka kasi ng paraan para makascore. It's not that ugly, it's not that beautiful. You have to find ways to score.
Correct. That's the objective. 2 points, ball in the hoop.
Now here comes Alex Konob playing his first moments dito sa ating tournament. Cortez. Kiamba will try. This time he misses. Battle for the rebound. And Keith Bato able to secure it for Rain or Shine.
Nice pass. Oh.
That was taken and intercepted by Alex Konob. So dating miyembro ng Gilas Youth as Raven Cortez. That was blocked by Jonar Clarito. Mm-hmm. Here comes Andre Caracut for Rain or Shine, still maintaining a 7-point lead. Active hands by De La Salle. Aaron Fuller in trouble. But he was called for a foul. That would be against Raven Cortez. With 5:09 remaining sa ating first period.
Magandang teaching point yung ginawa ni Clarito kanina. No? Off from a miss earlier. He went down. He went back on defense.
Uh-oh.
And yun, deflected that play. No? So... stop the ball.
It's all about the intangibles of this game.
True, true. So yun yung pwede natin matutunan dito sa mga pros na to.
That's a tough follow away for Aaron Fuller. That was a one-legged shot. Mintis nga lang. And here comes David Dungo. That's Matthew Robico. Misses the three-point shot. And good hustle by Raven Cortez. Robico has to kick it out. Alex Konov. That's his first three of the game. So that's in place 3x3 leads.
Oh, people are clapping. FF's coming in. So
that's right. That's Francis Escandor.
Right.
Yung first pick nila sa second round in the, this year's PBA draft.
I'm sure a lot of people are proud that Davaueño was selected to play in the PBA. No?
So, exactly. So a proud moment.
Yes, definitely.
Lalo na sa Escandor family.
Right. We're truly happy, no? Makita natin tong batang to from his Ateneo days.
Yeah, I mean,
to LaSalle,
in high school.
Yes,
tapos
yes.
At LaSalle.
Mm-hmm.
And now at the PBA.
Wow.
This time around, Jonar Clarito with another basket and one. And this time around for Francis Escandor, he'll be playing against his former team. Now, as we take a look at this replay, hatid sa inyo ng Bullet International Logistics Incorporated. That's another daredevil move for Jonar Clarito. At nagkaayawan ng fans dito sa USAP Gymnasium as Bo Belga. The Rain or Shine veteran now coming into the ball game.
Big Bo's in the house.
Big Bo, yes, that's right.
Bo's free throw for
They storied the PBA career. And there it is alongside Aaron Fuller. So, three-point play. Mintis nga lang yung bonus shot ni Jonar Clarito. So, it's 24-15. 9 points is the margin for Rain or Shine. Remember, De La Salle are the defending champions sa ating Kadayawan Invitational Basketball Tournament.
Right.
So, this will be a challenge here for La Salle as they're battling against the pros.
Yes.
And an offensive foul against Austria.
But I remember Austria has been an X-factor last year in their campaign here in Kadayawan.
I think he's one of the, I would say, mga defensive guards sa La Salle.
Aha, that's right, that's right. So, Francis Escandor finally checks in.
Checking in for the first time.
Right.
Now, playing against his former teammate, CJ Austria.
Some familiar faces, right?
For sure.
Mm-hmm.
Here comes Anton Asistio, former Ateneo Blue Eagle. Hands it off to Fuller. Balikang Asistio. This is a two-man game. Asistio. Looks to go on the drop-off pass and intercepted by La Salle.
A little bit of cat and mouse there, so. A turnover, though.
And Escandor trying to battle against CJ Austria.
Good defense from Francis Escandor.
Look at that active hands and defensive end for Francis.
Austria defense.
Escandor wins the battle.
Right.
How about that, Coach Cholo? Asistio for three. Yes! And that is his game since the days of Ateneo sa UAP.
Right.
I think that's a long two, I think, for Anton Asistio.
Excellent defense from Francis Escandor and an assist as well.
It's an outside shot for Anton Asistio.
Mm-hmm.
So, 12 na po ang abante ng Rain or Shine, approaching 2 minutes remaining sa ating first quarter. Alex Kornov, second three of the ball game. Nothing but net. So, yan yung range niya since yung days with the Gilas Youth Squad. Had played a couple of FIBA tournaments. Santillan rims out. And CJ Austria on the deck. And there's a foul, I think. Loose ball foul against CJ Austria. And now coming into the ball game for the first time, Mason Amos alongside Michael Phillips. And that's David Dungo now coming into the ball game for the La Salle Green Archers. So this is the first time for Mason Amos wearing a LaSallean jersey. So first sight for the Dabawenos.
Nakakapanibago, white and green, but here he is.
Yes, indeed, Coach Cholo. And here comes Mark Borboran. So isang veteranong PBA player.
Big goal!
Mintis nga lang yung first touch from the outside.
Mm-hmm.
And here comes De La Salle.
Oh, turnover.
And that's the thing that they needed to address for La Salle, their turnovers.
Yeah, they have to limit their turnovers. I think it's 27 points in one quarter. That's just huge, right? So they have to defend more.
Oh, especially right now, La Salle only is scoring 18 points. Escandor, off the handoff from Belga. Bibigay kang Mark Borboran. Asistio, see some daylight. Throws it up,
wow.
And scores. Quick 4 points for Anton Asistio. Now on the other side for La Salle, Michael Phillips. Now there's Marasigan. And Mason Amos, first touch of the basketball, off the handoff. Michael Phillips against Bo Belga. Magandang matchup yan at the front court, 7 to shoot. Si Austria, balikan Phillips for 2.
So you can finish.
So you can see yung good motor skills ni Michael Phillips.
That is right.
He's very fast for a front court player. Belga, nice ball fake on the drive and gets the two. Yan yung laruan niya since his early days in the PBA.
Umiiling-iling pa. Very familiar move from Belga, no?
We've seen that so many times in the pros. That's right.
Exactly.
Now here comes Amos against Borboran.
That should have been part of the scouting report.
Oh.
Right.
So, also a lot of accolades din for Bol Belga sa PBA. And there's that replay at sa inyo ng Davao City Sports Development Division. Ayun, no? Yung last play ni Bol Belga.
Muscles is in.
Oo.
Muscles in, no?
Here comes Phillips for La Salle. And we have a whistle.
Yari.
Looks like there's a problem with the shot clock, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So that was spotted by one of our referees. And that's from Marty Montoya, number 33.
He's very crucial with a shot blocker, no? Oo. Kanina pa yan eh. I think this is the second time.
So, isa sa ating mga referees from our friends from the Philippine Basketball Association, led by the commissioner, Mr. Willie Marshall.
Yeah, so I think we have 7 seconds in the first quarter, but we have 4 seconds on the shot clock, right?
At ang taas din yung scoring ng Rain or Shine, 31 points.
Yes, exactly.
And if you're LaSalle, that's unacceptable if you're LaSalle.
True, they have to limit their turnovers though. So, but again, this is just an early stage of the game, first quarter, a lot
that's
of
right.
time.
Katulad ng yung nangyari sa Converge at Phoenix yung previous game kanina. So it was a double-digit lead by Converge, nakakabawi ang Phoenix. And it was a tight race in the fourth quarter, but eventually in overtime, Converge wins it thanks to the efforts of Justin Arana and of course Alex Stockton, combined for 60 points.
Wow, 60.
Just from these two players, Stockton and Arana.
Mm-hmm.
So they're hoping they will continue their contribution as we go along sa ating tournament.
Right.
So referee Montoya still discussing to the scores table.
They have technical difficulties for the shot clock.
Right? Oh, so they're trying to make sure na eksakto yung oras. So it's now 7 seconds remaining dito sa ating first quarter.
In the game time, it's 4 seconds shot clock.
So 4 seconds ang shot clock.
4 seconds to shoot. 3, 2,
and there's the shot. It was blocked. Another block from Santi Santillan. And there's the heave by Belga. And that's the end of the first quarter. So high scoring affair for these two teams. But at the end of one is the Rain or Shine Elasto Painters takes a 31-20 lead at the end of the first quarter. So high scoring affair for the Elasto Painters at the end of the first quarter. So it's 31-20 for the Rain or Shine Elasto Painters. Carpio and of course Francis Escandor now playing for Rain or Shine. And he'll be starting in the second quarter alongside Mark Borboran, Anton Asistio, Bo Belga, and Leonard Santillan.
That is really the reality of college basketball. No?
Toto naman.
After the 4 or 5 years of the program that yung pinatakbo ninyo, the reality would be college players will really graduate, no? So they will move on to a higher stage. But the good thing about it is it would open up a lot of opportunities for the young guns.
As Escandor, first shot, mintis nga lang.
Mm-hmm.
And here comes the De La Salle, fast break. Open shot from the corner. And Amos scores his first field goal dito sa ating tournament as a La Salle player. Phillips to the steal. Look at that active hands for the big man. And Asistio able to win the battle as he draws the foul. So very scrappy play right down the court for Rain or Shine. So opening minutes ating second quarter. Once again, ako po si Ray Alonsagay. Kasama ko po si Coach Cholo Elihino. And here comes Leonard Santillan. Almost deflected. Escandor now in the paint. Kicks it out to Mark Borboran. So first shot from the baseline.
Mm-hmm. Another assist from Francis Escandor.
Now here comes Amos. He'll try for three.
Wow.
Yes!
Mason
quick 5 points for Mason Amos.
Showing us that range.
Oh. So he was part of the Gila squad. Especially nung FIBA tournaments.
Right. Yung nga na-mention mo, maraming nawala sa LaSalle, but you have these weapons, no? Coming in for the LaSalle na naman this year.
Oh. So. And Phillips drills a three.
So this would bring in a lot of promise for the La Salle program.
Oo.
Mm-hmm.
Lalo na si Michael Phillips. He actually played for Gilas Pilipinas during the Southeast Asian Games last year.
Yes.
Where he won the gold. Sa mga rotation players ng Gilas Pilipinas last year during the SEA Games sa Cambodia. So as he still with the inbounds, and here comes Mark Borboran. Now on the handoff, here's Francis Escandor looking for the first field goal of the game. Asistio inside to Bo Belga. Now against Michael Phillips. Magandang bakbakan to sa ilalim. Gets inside. So bangalang Infectus. Here comes the fast break by Lasal. Goliena in trouble as he was not able to receive the pass. And a turnover for Rain or Shine and Lasso Painters. But somehow De La Salle still within two possessions. So looks like Kevin Kiamba will check back in a few moments. Within the next dead ball. Oh, nice entry pass. Assist here for two. And that is the game for Bo Belga.
The vision of this big guy is remarkable, no?
Pasa yun. And that's why he has a storied PBA career for Bo Belga. Spanning over a decade sa PBA.
Mm-hmm.
Amos. Punta kang Mark Borboran. And that's the running shot.
Ibis nga lang.
So yan yung mga laruan talaga ni Mason Amos. Sa mga stretch bigs ni Coach Topex. As Santillan trying to overcome the challenge. Pero Michael Phillips wins the battle inside. And here comes Ramiro. Goliena for three. Yes! And it's now still a two-possession game.
Eli Goliena.
So that's Eli Goliena. First three of the game for him. So fast-paced game sa ating second quarter. And now coming into for the first time for LaSalle, that's Ethan Alian. And coming in also for the Rain or Shine last two Painters. That's Sean Ildefonso, one of the Ildefonso brothers.
Yes. Ngayon ang braso.
Oo.
Grabe.
So we just look at the rookie, Felix Lemeti, wearing number 2 ng Rain or Shine.
Uh-huh.
So papasok siya in a few moments.
Right.
Phillips from the perimeter. Mintes nga lang and Belga with another rebound for Rain or Shine. Now he looks down court. Hands it off to Sean Ildefonso. Borboran, hands it off. Francis Escandor, balikang Belga. 14 on the shot clock. Trying to go on the bounce pass and the ball was kicked. And that will reset to 14 seconds. And there's the first appearance for Felix Lemeti, who was the lottery pick of Rain or Shine in the recently concluded PBA draft. The Filipino-Swedish, standing 6'1".
Mm-hmm.
May tanga ng bola dito. Bibigay kang Belga. And that's an assist. First assist for Felix Lemeti.
Blowing kisses upstairs. Up to the heavens.
That's Bo Belga for you.
Right.
Since now 38-31. Taas pa rin ang scoring with 8 minutes still remaining in the first half. Kiambao. Tumakalalag. Mintis nga lang. Makalagag with another offensive rebound. So 14 on the shot clock. Kevin Kiambao. Now against Bo Belga, draws the foul. Smart play for KQ. At mukhang hindi nagustuhan doon ni Bo Belga. And that's the first personal foul for Bo Belga. And here's our replay hatid sa inyo ng lungsod ng Davao on that first assist and the 3-point shot for Bo Belga. And of course, blowing some kisses to the crowd, Coach Solo. And the first appearance at the foul line for Kevin Kiambao. A storied career in the UAAP as he misses the first free throw.
So KQ, we're looking at the future of Philippine basketball right here.
Yes, indeed. So he'll be playing another season sa UAAP. Looking to continue his MVP type career.
Mm-hmm.
Sa kanyang upcoming season sa UAP.
He's living the dream right now.
Oo. Now here comes Felix Lemeti and a first foul by Ethan Alian.
Holding foul jersey number 64. First personal foul on Ethan.
So first personal foul for Ethan Alian.
Second team foul.
Now here comes Felix Lemeti. With their lottery picks ng Rain or Shine. Borboran, balikang Lemeti. 10 to shoot. Sean, on the drive! Nipis nga lang yung tira doon sa ilalim. And here comes Goliena. Kevin Kiambao. Back out to Ethan Alian with 17 on the shot clock. Phillips, now against Aaron Fuller. Alian with 10 to shoot. Looks to Kevin Kiambao. Low post. Tough shot!
Wow!
Somehow it falls! And one!
Superb play inside for KQ. Superb indeed. Magical play for KQ. So ito ating replay, Coach. Hatid sa inyo ng The Royal Mandaya Hotel. Gandang bakbakan yun. Kiambao versus Ildefonso. You know, sweet touch ni Kevin Kiambao. And no wonder he's the season MVP and finals MVP sa UAAP last season. And he completes the three-point play.
Excellent stroke from the big guy. Huh?
So that's why he is the future.
Yes.
Of Philippine sure. basketball. For so sure. we're hoping that he'll have a promising professional career. Mm-hmm. And of course, his career with the national team sa Gilas Pilipinas. So no wonder maraming fans ang nagugustuhan sa pinakita ni KQ dito sa ating first half.
Yes, that's true.
Now here comes Lemepi. Sean Ildefonso has it. Bibigay kang borboran. Looks inside instead to Escandor. And there's that battle between Fuller and Phillips. Right-handed shot. Another rebound for Michael Phillips. So LaSalle now coming back. And Kiambao looks for the ball. Goliena for three. Good, and we're tied at 38.
It's a
three-point pass
in the jersey. Good stroke for number 32.
So napakabilis ang pagbawi ng LaSalle in the second period. Lemetti, great challenge by Michael Phillips. Loose ball, and Raynor Shine still has the basketball. Sean, wow. It's a three. So he has that outside touch as well for Sean Ildefonso.
Showing his range as well.
Exactly, Coach Solo. And here comes Goliena on the other end. Baseline jumper.
Nice. Open jumper for Goliena.
So looks to make some contributions dito sa ating tournament. And hopefully, mm-hmm. may pagpatuloy yan sa upcoming UAAP season.
That's right.
So Aaron Fuller. So having a difficult time against Michael Phillips. Escandor.
Pull-up jumper no good for Francis Escandor.
So he's still looking for his first field goal.
Mm-hmm.
Goliena, bullet pass to Makalalag. Layup is good. And that's poor transition defense for Raynor Shine. So it's 42-41. Lamang na po ng isa ang LaSalle. Dito sa ating second quarter. Lemetti in trouble. Allen with the steal. And the layup. Second straight layup for De La Salle. 44-41.
Full press now for LaSalle.
And wow. Fuller gets the basket to go and one.
The power of Fuller in this play.
Exactly. And a foul against Michael Phillips. And here's our replay. Hatid sa inyo ng Genesis 88 Construction. That's a power move inside for the veteran import, Aaron Fuller. With an illustrious basketball career, especially internationally. Played for several leagues in many countries. Mula sa New Zealand, Europe, hanggang South America. And now playing back in the PBA with the Raynor Shine, the Lasto Painters. Mintis nga lang yung three-point play niya. And here comes LaSalle as they're still up by one. So looks like the defense has ramped up for LaSalle in the second quarter, ano?
That's right.
As Makalalag draws the foul.
Yung tinatawag the fight back of LaSalle.
Tama ka dyan, Coach Solo. Kasi yung Raynor Shine, they were up as much as double digits. Especially in the first quarter. Pero ngayon, di kita ang ating labanan. And LaSalle only up by one. So the powerhouse UAP team, the defending champions, looking to make a statement against the Raynor Shine squad. So first appearance at the foul line for John Makalalag. As he misses the first free throw. Uy, Coach Solo, ating patitingin natin ating mga kaibigan. Si Coach Rocky Mejos and Coach Wawa Lamano.
Mm-hmm. They're now in Manila, participating in BPBL. Congrats to both of you. Congrats to our coaches. But, yeah. We were cheering for you, actually, guys.
Oo. But still, congratulations to Coach Rocky and Coach Wawa Lamano.
Yes.
Leading their respective teams to a superb campaign sa Batang Pilipino Basketball League.
Mm-hmm.
It's still ongoing sa Maynila.
Oo.
Si Coach Rocky is coaching the men's team. Samantala si Coach Wawa
assisting the women's team.
The women's team. No, yeah. That's right.
Head coach is Coach Gerald Amancio.
Ayun. So shout out to Coach Amancio.
Right.
And a steal. And here comes Raynor Shine. And a drive and a foul call against John Makalalag. So that's Adrian Nokum playing college basketball for the Mapua squad.
sa NCAA. So itong si
that's the 15th foul of the Green Hunters.
So that's the first appearance of the foul line for Adrian Nokum. Is nga lang yung first free throw. Ito si Adrian Nokum. He was the last pick of the second round in the 2023 PBA draft. But have a decent scoring performance in the Philippine Cup, averaging about 12.8 points per game. As he makes the second free throw. So tabla na po tayo at 44. And we're approaching 4.5 minutes remaining. Kiambao off the pick. And Datu secures the rebound. Here comes Lemetti. Now manning the point for the Inner Shine. Datu. Ibigay kong shot Ildefonso. And there's a pick by Fuller. Now Fuller receives the pass. Balik ang Ildefonso. Goes on the extra pass and not a good idea. That was taken away. A lot of traffic underneath. And that was a sorry pass in transition. Medyo na palakas lalang yung pasa. Malakang KQ.
Too much sauce in the pass.
Oo. And now coming in for Reno Shine. That's the former Atenean player, Gian Mamuyak.
Mamuyak, yes.
Naalala ko pa siya na naglalaro sa Jesuit Athletic Meet some years ago.
True. That was
2016,
okay.
And of course, a former Batangilas player, if I'm not mistaken, si Gian Mamuyak. And Lemetti shot is missed. Offensive rebound by Datu. And here comes Mamuyak. And now in the hands of Adrian Nokum. Back to Felix Lemetti with 5 to shoot. Mamu to Keith Datu. Three-pointer is missed. So the shots have not fallen dito sa ating second quarter for Rainer Shine.
Agaw.
Yun, yung nagawa ni Felix Lemetti. Balik ang Mamu. Kontra ang KQ. Keith Datu for three.
Still firing, but
so, miss. Rainer Shine jacking up some outside shots. Pero maraming mga empty trips dito sa ating second period. Only scoring about 14 points. 13 points rather in the second quarter. Samantalang LaSalle, if I'm not mistaken, scoring 24 points in the second period.
Yeah, Rainer Shine is struggling in the second quarter. Now that is the reason why De La Salle also caught up with the deficit earlier.
Oo. No? Kaya tabla na po tayo at 44. 3 minutes remaining. But of course, Bongo from the corner.
Yes.
Austria picks it up and gets the two.
Credit also to the defense of De La Salle. No? They're leading now by 2 points.
Yung scrambling na pressure on defense.
Yes.
So, nagpapakitang gilas na ang LaSalle against the professional Rain or Shine. The Fuller inside. Basket and that will count and a foul.
The De La Salle defense, that is really their trademark. No? For several years, college basketball, pag sabi mo De La Salle, malakas talaga yung depensa nila. No?
Yeah, they're known as one of the elite teams sa college basketball.
That's true.
Even yung time ni Richie Rivero when he was still playing for LaSalle. Or if that I'm not mistaken, Coach Cholo, even yung time na naglalaro si Jeron Teng,
yeah,
sa De La Salle.
Even right now in the I'm looking at the bench of De La Salle.
Oh,
some familiar face. Nakalaro namin to sa university games, eh, si I think Coach Monose, no?
Ah. Mm. Sa mga veteranong coaches sa La Salle.
Malakas yung defense sila at that time. Teammates sila Cortez. The cool cat.
Ah, Mike Cortez. Yes. Who's the father of Raven Cortez. Who's not around this evening. And Aaron Fuller with the big rebound. And here comes Rain or Shine. As they're leading by one with 2 minutes remaining sa ating first half. Adrian Nokum. Cross court to Keith Datu. Inside to Aaron Fuller against Raven Cortez. And a quick steal by La Salle. So the defense has ramped up in the second period for LaSalle.
Wow.
Adam skying for two.
EJ.
And the lead has changed hands several times for both LaSalle and Rainer Shine. So a seesaw battle sa ating second period. So approaching a minute and 45 sa ating first half. Looks inside to Aaron Fuller against Alex Konov. Keith Datu. Another miss from the three-point country.
Third missed three-point shot for Datu.
And Konov running the floor for two.
Alex Konov.
So, impressive play na pinakita ni Alex Konov dito sa ating first half. Lalo ng mga 3-point shots niya na binibigay for LaSalle. It's now 3-point lead, 50-47. Here comes Gian Mamuyak. Stops on a dime. And Nokum cleans it up. So that's Adrian Nokum.
Adrian Nokum.
Who averages about 4 rebounds per game in the Philippine Cup sa PBA. So able to cut the deficit to within 1. On the other side, here comes LaSalle. Good ball rotation. Konov, that's a 3.
Lethal from the rainbow area.
If I'm not mistaken, that's his third 3.
Yes. Yes. I think so.
Yan yung laruan talaga mula nung naglaro siya sa Gilas Youth Program. Mamu's shot is missed. And here comes Raven Cortez for the LaSalle Green Archers. Looks inside to see to Cyrus Austria. Now against Mamu. Teka. And the referee has to step in to, defuse the tension.
LaSalle Ateneo.
Oh, LaSalle Ateneo kasi. Si Gian Mamuya, former Atenean player. Now playing against a current LaSallean player. So the referees will approach the replay monitor. So that's referee number 22, Sherwin Pineda. Sa mga veteranong referee sa PBA. And there's Gabe Norwood mentoring the rookie, Felix Lemeti.
Right. Mamu won't back down, no?
Oo.
From that play.
And considering si Gian Mamuya has that long wingspan of his, so that's why he has one of the good defenders during their run sa Ateneo Blue Eagles sa UAP.
Mm-hmm.
So 25 seconds remaining. So referee Sherwin Pineda still checking the replay dito sa ating replay table. And there's the look of the coaching staff ng LaSalle, led by their, of course, champion coach Topex Robinson. An illustrious coaching career magmula sa kanyang career sa NCAA sa Lyceum of the Philippines. So ano kaya magiging tawag dito as referee Pineda now discussing at the scorer's table alongside our game announcer, Mr. Leroy Salarda. So foul against Gian Mamuya.
I see.
So a double technical,
right?
Sa pagitan ng Mamuya and Austria.
Mm-hmm.
So Coach Yang Giao now seeking an explanation from referee Pineda.
He's putting his case. Nag-swing daw ng elbow eh. So yun.
So it's a timeout as De La Salle Green Archers takes a 53-49 lead. And Coach Topex Robinson looks a little bit confused on that last call. But nevertheless, La Salle still has the basketball, looking to finish strong sa ating first half. Now CJ Austria looks for the inbounds and almost knocked away. Last touch by Adrian Nokum.
Excited na ako sa second half eh, kasi LaSalle is on top and I'm sure this will fuel rain or shine, no?
Added motivation kumbaga, lalo na for Coach Yang Giao.
Tingin ko. So this will be interesting second half.
And by the way, his first appearance for Luis Pablo in a LaSalle uniform. So formerly played for the UP Fighting Maroons.
Ooh.
That basket goes and one for EJ Abadam.
2 points, no?
And N1 opportunity pa for Abadam. And there's that last replay, Coach Chola, hatid sa inyo ng Arcadia Active Lifestyle Center. Able to absorb contact off the crossover from Mamuyak and gets the basket to go. Steady play for EJ Abadam, pero mintis nga lang yung 3-point opportunity niya. And we're down to 8 seconds. Lemeti looking for the last shot. And that was deflected by Luis Pablo. Playing high school basketball for the LaSalle Benilda program. LaSalle Green Hills, if I'm not mistaken. For Luis Pablo. So 4.4 seconds remaining. And there's the look of Coach Topex Robinson. Manning the sidelines for LaSalle. Giving some instructions to EJ Abadam. 4.4 seconds remaining. Nokum
looking for the last shot. Fuller at the buzzer and was fouled on the three-point shot.
Wow.
So a chance for Fuller to salvage some points, yes, at the end of the first half.
Bad foul.
That's a bad foul indeed from LaSalle. So three shots, I think, for Aaron Fuller. This nga lang yung unang free throw. Still has two more from the foul line. Looking to close out strong for the import ng Rain or Shine. It's the second. So Aaron Fuller looking to make some contributions for Rain or Shine dito sa ating tournament. And hits 2-for-3 from the foul line. And that's the end of the first half. So a tight battle between the UAP champion and the PBA squad as De La Salle Green Archers takes a 55-51 lead at halftime. Wow. In the second period alone.
So outscoring 15 points in the second period. So that's a good turnaround, the fight back from De La Salle. But I'm curious with the response of Rain or Shine in the second half. Let's see. It remains to be seen. So,
tingnan natin ang kanyang adjustments led by the veteran head coach, isang legendary head coach.
Of course.
Yang Kiao.
Of course, idol natin yan, no?
Absolutely. Yang
Kiao, yes.
So once again, ako po si Ray Alonsagay. Kasama ko po ang head coach ng Holy Cross of Davao College, Cholo Elehino. And third quarter now underway. And here comes the first touch from the outside. Mintis nga lang for De La Salle. And here comes Rain or Shine. Only down by 4 though sa ating third quarter. And here comes Lo Belga at the post. That's a great battle against Kevin Kiambao. Kicks it out to Santi. And easy rebound for Kevin Kiambao. David Dungo, left-handed layup. Mintis nga lang. And rebound by Aaron Fuller. So the leading scorer for Rain or Shine with 13 points in the first half. Mamu, hang time. That's good.
Gian Mamuya.
And that's the first field goal for Gian Mamuya. And Rain or Shine only down by 2.
Miscommunication there.
So turnover yan, Coach Cholo. Mapunta sa Rain or Shine.
Uh-huh. So I think Rain or Shine could possibly look for Fuller in the second half more. No? I think he'll have more touches in the second half.
Definitely, for sure, Coach Cholo as LaSalle playing without their yung foreign student athlete nila.
Oh, okay.
Na si Henry Aguane.
Same scenario, miscommunication.
So turnover on the other side for Rain or Shine. So speaking of Henry Aguane, he was one of the key contributors sa kanyang dating team na Centro Escolar University. Doon sa kanyang kampanya sa UCBL. What a pass from Kevin Kiambao, able to spot. Beautiful. The cutting goal, Yena.
Backdoor play.
An all-around game for Kevin Kiambao, just like his campaign sa UAP. That's Bo Belga against a double team. Basket counts and the foul. Oh, wait a minute. Belga got hooked by Goliena. Yan ang maasahan natin, especially when you're facing against Big Bo.
You don't want to be tangled with Big Bo. Right?
Oh.
No. I'd rather walk away, coach. That's a ray.
So there's that last play. Hatid sa inyo ng The Royal Manday Hotel. Bo Belga overcoming the double team of LaSalle. And there's a little tangle up. Sa pagitan ni Goliena and Bo Belga.
Bah, isang kamay, oh.
Oh, yan yung usual free throw shooting routine ni Bo Belga recently in the PBA.
Yes.
Where somehow it swishes it in. Mm-hmm. Here comes Dungo for 3. And ball will sail out of bounds. And that will go to Rain or Shine. This could be an interesting one in the second half.
Yeah, like I said, no retaliation for coming from Rain or Shine.
Now in the hands of Bo Belga. Takes the handoff, and that was ball kicked by Kevin Kiambao. So 2 minutes gone by, starting third quarter.
In the span of about 2 minutes, they have, I think they've shown a lot of energy in the second half, no? Medyo maganda yung pace na ginagawa ngayon ng Rain or Shine.
But on the other side, here comes LaSalle on the run. Goliena stops on a dime. That's good. Nothing but net.
Pull-up jumper.
So that's Goliena's jump shot. And that's LaSalle now has a 3-point lead.
Coach Yang also extending minutes for Mamo, no?
Oo.
Oh.
So trying to give his impact sa even though he's not producing a lot of stats on the stat sheet, pero siguro yung mga quality plays, mga intangibles ni Mamuyak, trying to show some contribution for Reno Shine. Yeah. Here comes Fuller against a double treat team. Nitis nga lang yung layup and Kiambao, there's the bullet pass. Not a good idea. And here comes Mamu.
So the aggressiveness, the hustle plays coming from Mamuyak.
Balik up Fuller.
And there you go.
And that's an easy two for Aaron Fuller. Now has 15 points.
Ayan na naman, 3 points.
Nitis nga lang for Kevin Kiambao.
See, faster pace this time for Reno Shine.
And that's a one-handed shot. That's a fadeaway for Andre Karakut. And Reno Shine takes the lead by one. 60-59. So, a high-scoring affair for these two teams. And another tussle. A little bit of a tussle. Pero foul called against Bo Belga.
Pasimple lang. Simple tulak lang.
Some sort of antics.
Definitely. But it's really fun to watch. No?
Oo. Lalo na pag andyan si Bo Belga sa Reno Shine.
True.
Trying to, give some entertainment to the Davaoeno fans dito sa USEP Gymnasium. Mm-hmm. Marami pa rin nanonood dito sa ating second and final game for our first day of competition. And that shot was missed. Offensive rebound, Marasigan. Now, offensive rebound, nice pass! Nako! Kapos nga lang yung tira ni Austria. But Phillips gets it back and scores! And first field goal for Michael Phillips dito sa ating second half.
Ooh.
And wow, I think that's a moving screen.
Yeah, and extend niya yung paa niya.
Offensive foul on jersey 28, Bo Belga. That's the third. That's a good idea for Bo Belga as to walk away.
True.
As, Bo Belga now has his third personal foul. Second team foul for the Alasto Painters. Now here comes CJ Austria. Using a pick by Kevin Kiambao. Mintis nga lang. Bakbakan sa rebound and Fuller has it. And Reno Shine goes in transition. Fuller against Phillips. Draws the foul. So two shots coming up for the veteran import, Aaron Fuller.
Actually, this pace would favor Reno Shine. Because it's really not up and down. So looking at the play before this one, I mean, Reno Shine gave up about 4 offensive rebounds. If I were them, I hindi ko pwedeng i-allow yung ganong klaseng situation.
That's
why you have to change the pace, no? Kasi you have to enforce your pro team against a college team.
So see Aaron Fuller able to make his first free throw. Now 16 points, if I'm not mistaken, as Fuller. His last stint with the TNT Tropang Giga in the 2021 Governor's Cup, averaging a double-double of 17 points and 16 rebounds per contest.
Mm-hmm.
As he makes 2-for-2 from the foul line. So, balik sa isang abante ng Reno Shine. Kiambao from straight away. Hits a three! Steady shooter, Kevin Kiambao.
Exactly. Ice in his veins. Babawi. Big goal.
Kontra ang Kiambao. Gets the roll.
Save.
Makakabawi din ako. Sabi ni Bobo.
Naman.
So there's our replay, Coach Cholo. Hatid sa inyo ng Genesis 88 Construction.
Parang Dirk Nowitzki.
Oo.
Tirang yun eh.
Diba? For a 6'5 guy, Bo Belga.
Sabay finger wag pa, no?
Oo. Sabi ni Kevin Kiambao, may ano pa ako, may bibigay pa ako na lesson sa iyo, bata. Ayun, katanggap ng free lesson mula kang Bo Belga, si KQ.
Right, maangas pa rin eh.
Oo.
So, Kiambao finished with his 3-point shot earlier.
Bo Belga naman, nakakomplete ng 3-point play. He'll try for 3.
Yeah, yes, traditional 3-point play as well for Belga.
Ito, si Belga.
Yan na naman.
Pareho sila number 28, ano?
Fuller.
What's big? Nakakalabaw sa ilalim. Yes, sir. Yes, and one. So Aaron Fuller muscling his way inside.
Yun ang sabi ko kanina, they have to look for Fuller more.
Oo.
Kasi in terms of matchup, I think he has the distinct advantage in the paint, ano?
So there's the replay hatid sa inyo ng Bullet International Logistics Incorporated. That's a powerful move for Aaron Fuller, the veteran import.
Enforcing his way.
So he's trying to make a force underneath the basket for Rain or Shine, especially for the upcoming Commissioner's Cup.
Mm-hmm.
3-point opportunity for Aaron Fuller. Yes, sir.
Wow. I think 20 plus points na to si Fuller, no?
Yes, indeed. And there's Coach Yang Giao as Rain or Shine takes a 4-point lead.
Matthew Rubico. Ganda ng ball movement ng Lasal. Gumagalaw.
Oo. Nobody sticking the basketball as yes. Malasigan drills the jump shot.
Ball movement, people movement. Ganda tingnan, ganda panoorin.
Unselfish basketball, kumbaga, yes. For Lasal on that last play.
That should be. Ganun talaga dapat palaruin yung basketball. Hindi yung isolation.
As Mamuyak makes the jump shot, trying to draw the foul but no whistle. And here comes Marasigan.
Oh,
and a blocking foul by Gian Mamuya.
Kala ko offensive foul eh.
Blocking. Pero si Mamuyak was moving, kaya natawagan siya ng blocking foul.
He was reaching also, so
oo. He's not establishing a defensive position. Kasi you have to establish your defensive position if you want to draw the charge, kumbaga.
Gian has been playing since second period, right? In the,
yeah,
the down the last 2-3 minutes to play in the second period. So up until now.
So yan yung trust na binibigay ng youngster na si Gian Mamuyak.
Correct. Kailangan nila yung aggressiveness ni Gian eh. Both on the offensive and the defensive end. So that's why he's there. Huh?
That's right.
He is the X factor now. So he's not scoring a bunch of points, but he's very effective,
especially on the defensive end.
Yes, that's true.
Now here comes Mamu with 10 to shoot.
See?
Nice pass. Fuller. Grabe yung execution ni Mamu. That's a two-man game between Mamu and Fuller.
Kita mo yung IQ ng batang to, no?
So there's the replay at sa inyo ng Arcadia Active Lifestyle Center. Nice turnaround for Gian Mamuyak. So two more shots coming up for Aaron Fuller as he makes the first. At babalik na dito si Alex Konov. So si Alex Konov in the first half, perfect from the three-point line, 3 of 3.
Wow.
Kaya hindi nakakagulat na they're shooting above 50% from three-point line in the first half.
Well, let's see if he can sustain that in the second quarter, in the second half, no? Gandang matchup to in the point guard position.
Now here comes Luis Pablo. Ibigay kang that's Rubico. Now against Andre Caracut, the former Lasallian. Konov for 3.
What?
Got it! Still perfect, Coach Cholo.
Right where he left off, no? Galeng. Catch and shoot.
Oh,
ready to fire. Hesitation dribble from Mamuyak.
And looks like a ball last touch by CJ Austria. So Alex Kornov now has 14 points. 5:38 remaining sa ating third quarter. 71-69. Dikit pa rin ating labanan but a high scoring game. Parehas yung first game kanina, Coach Cholo, as Mamuyak off the inbounds. Itis nga lang yung 3-point shot, rebound by Alex Konov.
Right, I think the crowd doesn't mind, no? Having a high-scoring ball game.
So, kasi grabe yung intensity sa pagitan ng dalawang koponan. Just like yung first game kanina.
Correct.
Sa pagitan ng Phoenix at ng Converge, but Converge win it in overtime.
Second personal foul on Alex.
So natawagan ng ikalawang personal foul kontra kang Alex Konov. 5:25 remaining sa ating third quarter. So penalty na ang Lasal. So two shots coming up for the former Lasallian, Leonard Santi Santillan. So native of Cebu. So shoutout natin sa mga kaibigan dyan mula sa Cebu. So I hope you're watching sa ating live stream sa Madayal Sports Davao.
I think this is from, he's from UV, right?
Yeah, he's playing, he played college basketball sa Cebu before he went to Lasal.
Yes.
And makes the second free throw.
I'm looking at Coach Yang, you know, so very composed, very calm.
Oo.
So barking out instructions to his players. Let's see in the fourth quarter if his demeanor will change, you know.
Tingnan natin ano mangyayari sa remainder ng second half. because we have seen it multiple times in the PBA.
Scanning the crowd, I'm looking at also Coach Caloy Garcia in the crowd, just watching, observing.
So great action we're seeing here sa ating second and final game, and this is just the first day sa ating 4-day Invitational Basketball Tournament, part of the 39th Kadayawan Festival.
Right.
Day Pablo. And that was, yeah, easy steal for Leonard Santillan, able to jump out the pass. Nokom. Balik ang Andre Karakut. That's a tough fall away. Wow. And somehow it goes for Aaron Fuller. So Rainer Schein keep feeding on the big guy. 75-69. Ball is loose. And fast break opportunity for Rainer Schein.
Uh-oh.
And Nokom diving into the crowd sa Yusef Gymnasium. So that's a risk if you're watching mula sa baseline dito po sa Yusef Gymnasium, kasi you won't know na and somebody is down. Alex Konov
hurt himself.
Nasaktan. No, yeah, wait. That's right.
Ow.
Looks like he's holding on to his left ankle.
Yeah,
I think so. I think you saw that, coach, what happened.
I just saw him twitched and fell down. No, did not really see what happened to him.
So yung sinabi mo, coach, he hurt himself.
Yeah.
On that last sequence.
Probably twisted his ankle, rolled his ankle. I don't know.
So we're hoping nothing serious for Alex Konov.
Yeah. I mean, this guy played really well in this game. I think he scored four triples already, right?
14 points pa for Alex Konov.
Yeah. He's been very effective for De La Salle, and it would be a costly.
And Alex Kolov still in pain.
Wow.
So we're hoping nothing is serious.
Oh, he's limping.
So he's limping back to the De La Salle bench for Alex Kolov. So nevertheless, a great production for Alex Kolov with four triples throughout sa ating ball game for La Salle. So a great contribution for the youngster, Alex Konov. So papalitan siya ni Mason Amos.
Another guy who can shoot threes.
That's for sure. We have seen that multiple times, especially during his days wearing his jersey with Gilas Pilipinas.
Blue and white, right?
For sure. Austria trap underneath. Lots of scrambling plays on the defensive end for Rainer Schein, pero natawagan ng foul. Fouls in jersey number 8, Anton Asistio. So Anton Asistio with the personal foul. So medyo bumagal na ang pace na ating nakita sa ating third quarter, Coach Solo.
Because Rainer Schein controlled the pace, simply, no?
So
again, like I said, this would favor Rainer Schein.
That was a bad miss. Mula kang marasigan mula sa tres. Nokom skying! And Fuller cleans it up.
There you go. Bumabalik agad yung Rainer Sain eh. Preventing De La Salle to run.
Mabilis talaga yung pagbaba sa depensa ang Rainer Sain as Amos for a good catch and finish.
Yes.
77-71. So under 4 minutes remaining.
Tighter defense now for Rainer Sain.
Teka lang, natawagan ng offensive foul against Anton Asistio. And that's two fouls for Anton Asistio dito sa ating third quarter.
Konov still grimacing in pain. I'm looking at him. Really hate to see a player fall down, no? After a very good game and this injury hit him, no? Masakit yan, kawawa yung bata. I hope and pray that he's okay.
Exactly. So prayers up for Alex Konov, hoping nothing serious on that injury sa kanyang left ankle. CJ Austria, and left side jumper is good. 77-73.
CJ Austria.
Here comes Clarito. Here comes the veteran Mark Borboran. Asistio. Keith Dato now against Mason Amos. Hands it off. Anton Asistio, nice lob, but Dato trapped underneath. Nokum will fight to shoot. And stolen by CJ Austria. Active hands at the defensive end. Austria goes to the cup.
CJ
and down
Austria
to a 2-point game, Coach Cholo.
credits to Austria. I mean, he made that happen, no?
3 minutes.
So no wonder he's one of the pesky defenders for LaSalle. I've seen that since last season. Oh. And another foul against LaSalle.
Iinit yung ulo mo eh pag siya yung kaharap mo, no? Very pesky, that's the word, oh. Yes.
See, if you're matching up against Austria, you get annoyed by his active hands on the defensive end. Pero if you're the side of LaSalle, you'll definitely appreciate yung value na binibigay ni CG Austria.
Mm.
As Datu misses the first free throw.
Yeah, looking at his structure, no, his body structure, hindi naman siya ganun ka muscular, no?
Hindi naman ganun siya athletic, tama right, ka right. Solo, but
he's very effective.
Oo. Especially mataas yung IQ niya,
yun.
Lalo na sa depensa.
Correct. That's right. That is his value for De La Salle.
Like, it doesn't matter if he has a lot of points, but yung mga defensive smarts na binibigay ni CG Austria really making a difference for La Salle. So I believe that's one of the reasons why he's one of the contributors of the La Salle roster last season sa UAP.
Correct. That's true.
So babalik sa bench si Luis Pablo as Raven Cortez now back in the lineup for the De La Salle Green Archers. Another 3 minutes remaining sa ating third period.
Wow!
The crossover to the cup! What a move by Ethan Alian.
Coach Topex applauded that move.
Ang bilis nung nung crossover ni binigay ni Alian. Kaya napatayo ang La Salle bench, ano? That was nasty.
True.
So two shots coming up for Alian.
Oh.
Malakas nga lang yung una.
Minadali niya yung tira eh. You have to stay balanced when you shoot that free throw.
Medyo off balance yung first free throw niya eh.
He's leaning forward.
Second shot.
Still the same.
Empty trips from the foul line for Alian. Still a two-point game. Rain or shine still has a precarious lead. Borboran. Hands it off to Anton Asistio. In the paint. Fade away. Mintis nga lang. And Cortez secures the rebound. Sama niya si Alian, Abadam, Austria and Amos. That's a five on the floor for La Salle. CJ Austria manning the point. Goes inside, spins, wheeling and dealing and scoring.
Throwing that elbow again, but finished off with an N1 play.
That's the aggressiveness we're talking about, Coach Acholo.
The grit.
Mm. And there's the replay hatid sa inyo ng Davao City Sports Development Division. So that's a foul against Mark Borboran.
The future is bright for this young guy, number 16 Austria.
Lalo na kung papasok na sa lineup ang LaSalle in the upcoming the next season, so
yes.
Season 88. Kian Baklaan and Raven Cortez. So a lot of guards coming up for LaSalle coming to next season. Sa UAP as Clarito, there's some contact underneath and a foul was called. Looks like against Austria.
Pushing foul jersey number 16, CJ
Austria. So both teams in the penalty situation. As the veteran, Jonar Clarito will troop to the line for his two free throw shots.
Two free throws for Jonar Clarito.
So dati po siya naglalaro sa MPBL. Now playing for Rain or Shine, last two painters.
Yeah, they badly need another scorer, no? Aside from Fuller, Rain or Shine needs another scorer.
Yung tinatawag na secondary scorer, no?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Clarito has been doing that in the first half, but in the second half, not yet.
Medyo minalas na siya from the foul line, 0-4-2. Right. As De La Salle now has the lead by 1, 78-77.
So nakita natin after Fuller went out, no? Rain or Shine struggled immediately to score.
Medyo umiba na yung timpla, kumbaga, ang Rain or Shine. Since Fuller stopped out, as Keith Datu now replacing Fuller. Under 2 minutes remaining sa ating third quarter. 8-2 shoot for Abadam. EJ against Asistio. Goes in the paint. Mintis nga lang yung layup. And easy rebound for Keith Datu.
Everything but the shot, no?
Exactly.
Oh,
almost a steal but Asistio able to recover. Keith Datu. Back to Asistio with 12 to shoot.
Uh-oh.
And away from the play, foul against... That's Goliena with the personal foul. As he apologizes to Coach Topex Robinson. So two shots coming up this time from Mark Borboran. Sa mga veteranong players sa Rain or Shine, played a long time in the PBA. Kasi dati po siyang player ng University of the East sa UAAP many years ago. Still producing a lot of points for Rain or Shine as he hits the second. So we're tied at 78 with a minute and 23 remaining.
Coach Yang closely studying the game.
Oh, oh. And look, I'm watching at Coach Yang's reaction after that last foul. Second personal foul, Martin. He's looks disappointed at that last foul kasi penalty na kasi ang Rain or Shine. So that means two shots for Ethan Alian. But remember, he had two missed shots from the foul line for Ethan Alian. Third straight miss.
You can see the respect from the referees, no? When Coach Yang asked for clarification, the referee sprint.
Oh, that's referee Brian Peclaro.
Yeah.
Talking with Coach Yang Giao. Fourth straight sprint, miss. No? Maraming na mga mintis dito for Ethan Alian. 0-4 from the foul line sa ating third period. Clarito. And look at that defense. Aggressive defense ng LaSalle. Asistio. We tend to shoot.
Bah.
And Alian wins the battle against Asistio as he commits the personal foul against Anton. And Anton seeks an explanation from the referee. And that's the third personal foul for Anton Asistio in the third quarter alone. So the defense has ramped up for LaSalle dito sa third quarter. And 1 minute remaining. And ma-feel yung atmosphere dito sa USAP Gymnasium. They're anticipating an intense fourth quarter ahead. Ma-feel ko na Coach Solo eh.
Overtime ba to?
I'm not sure. Could be. Who knows? And the shot is good off the glass for Mason Amos.
Mason Amos!
At dalawa na po ang abante ng LaSalle. 29 seconds remaining sa ating third period. Asistio. Pull-up jumper. That was a sorry miss for Anton. Really struggling from the outside. And looks like Adrian Nocum is complaining to one of the referees.
Finally, I've heard the voice of Coach Yang. Screaming.
Ngayon lang, ano?
Oo. Oh. Nag-warm up lang yun eh, kanina eh.
Oo. Here comes Nocum off the crossover. Great defense by Adbadam.
Oh,
not well, anything but the shot there for Adrian Nocum. And we're down to 12 seconds. Alian. Now here comes Raven Cortez. Last shot opportunity for LaSalle. Amos. Step back three. In and out. And we're down to 2 seconds. And we have a foul.
Oh.
And much to the dismay of Jonar Clarito. With 1.3 seconds remaining. And that means free throws kasi kanina lang pong penalty na ang Rain or Shine. And Coach Yang seeking an explanation from referee Marty Montoya. And Jonard also talking to referee Marty Montoya trying to look for an explanation bakit siya na-foul doon on that last play. But nevertheless, two shots coming up for Ethan Alian. Finally hits the first free throw.
Really impressed with LaSalle, ano?
Lalo na yung depensa nila, no?
Yeah. Not backing down against the pros.
So the defending champions of the UAAP making a statement against Rain or Shine. Mm-hmm. And he goes perfect. 1.3 seconds. Clarito at the buzzer. And there's a little antics pa at the end of the third quarter. But nevertheless, we have a fourth quarter coming up dito po sa University of Southeastern Philippines Gymnasium dito po sa Davao City. It's now 82-78, still in favor of LaSalle. Oh boy, this could be a great battle coming up sa ating fourth quarter, Coach Solo.
Yes, indeed. Excited to watch the fourth quarter. Stay tuned. Stay tuned, guys.
So it's 82-78 for the LaSalle Green Archers. Archers contra sa Rain or Shine Elastro Painters of the PBA. And of course, ating i-shoutout ating mga kaibigan mula sa Samahang Basketball ng Pilipinas Region 11. Who's also watching right now. Dito sa loob ng USAP Gymnasium as that shot missed by Jonard Clarito. He thought it was fouled. Here comes Kevin Kiambao. No look pass to Cortez for two. What a play for Kevin Kiambao.
Rain or Shine needs to watch out, no? It's the leading is getting bigger now.
Anim na po ang abante ng Rain or Shine. Jonard Clarito. That's a bad miss from three. And here comes LaSalle. And Rain or Shine really struggling to start the fourth quarter. As Clarito diving to the sidelines sa ating venue.
Sira.
Bukang nasira yung upuan, no? Mga plastic chairs.
That's right.
That's the courtside.
Okay. Yes.
So I hope yung mga nanonood dyan sa courtside, they're doing okay. So action continues. Clarito.
Wow.
Aggressive strong. For two and one.
Omoya.
So, one more shot coming up for Jonard Clarito. So, look at this aggressive move from the baseline. Atid sa inyo ng The Royal Monday Hotel for the veteran, Jonard Clarito. And that is his game since his days in the Maharlika Pilipinas Basketball League many years ago. And completes the three-point play.
Cutting down the lead to three.
Still plenty of basketball naman. Still a minute gone by sa ating fourth quarter. So this could be a great fourth quarter just like yung una sa pagitan ng Converge at ang Phoenix. Where Converge won in overtime. Makalalag. That's a tough shot. Somehow it falls.
Nice shot. Oh.
Borboran for three. Knocks it down. So biglang bawi doon ng Rain or Shine courtesy of that outside shot mula kang Mark Borboran.
It's a needed basket.
Oh, what a pass! As Kiambao draws the foul. As Adrian Nokum recognizes he committed that personal foul. So itong si Adrian Nokum, looks like he's sending a message to Kevin, no easy baskets. Para sa'yo, Kevin. I think that no surprise din na Coach Solo na I have read multiple times online na lalo na sa mga foreign na teams na bumibisita dito sa Pilipinas na parang iba yung aggressive style of play sa PBA. As we take a look at this replay, atid sa inyo ng Genesis 88 Construction, and that's from Mark Borboran.
Substitution for the Nasa Painters.
Yan yung mga sinasabi kasi ng mga foreign teams who have played against our local teams or even national teams na iba yung style of play. Ating mga local teams, yung Filipino teams, ibang iba, very aggressive, very physical.
Sanay tayo dyan eh.
Oo.
Oo. But the thing about our style of game is that I would say we're parang naka-pattern yung type of play natin sa NBA.
So
similar, halos similar rules with the NBA.
Oo.
Sa PBA natin.
Kasi if I'm not mistaken, it's a hybrid of of course, the NBA and PBA, FIBA rules, kumbaga.
Yes, yes. So, makita natin yung style of play natin, no? As compared to our Southeast Asia neighbors, no? I think, I would say more athletic compared to them. So, yun na nga, mas magaling tayo dun sa isolation basketball.
Oh.
Very athletic yung mga players ng Philippines, no?
Especially in the past several years, we've seen a lot of athletic players. Now coming into Philippine basketball, even dito sa ating college basketball level.
Makita natin yung mga crafty moves.
Yung mga one-on-one plays.
Yes, yes.
Like yung nakita natin kanina sa first game, pagitan ng Converge at ng Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
Diyan makalalag. Oh!
Ba?
Looks like there's a tussle between Goliena and Clarito. Akala ko madamay na yung tao na nanonood sa courtside eh.
Yan naman, ano? Sila pa rin yun eh.
Oo. Almost the same spot. Coach Solo. And that's those are some of the risks if you're watching in the courtside.
Yes.
Kasi there will be some instances that players will die for loose balls.
Oh, libre pawis din yun eh.
So those are the risks.
Oo. But so you're close to the action.
Oo, yun na. Man. So what action we're seeing, and this is just the first game, our first day rather.
Right.
Wow. A lot of great moments indeed on our first game sa ating Kadayawan Invitational Basketball Tournament. So this is definitely a great treat for the fans as Andre Caracut gets the shot to go. It's now down to a two-point game, 88-86. David Dungo, konda kang Keith Batu. Quick spin move. Mintis nga lang.
Bigay, ayun. Hindi nakita si Clarito.
Now it comes Caracut. Gives it up to Jonard. Malakas nga lang yung three-point shot.
Stepping.
And looks like it is. Raven Cortez stepped out of bounds. At babalik sa ballgame si Leonard Santillan ng Rain or Shine. Samantala, for De La Salle, that's Lian Ramiro and Michael Phillips now back in the ball game. And also Aaron Fuller will return to the ball game. So babalik sa bench si Mark Borboran playing some valuable minutes dito sa ating second half.
Yeah, Fuller is back in. Expect a bunch of points coming from him again. This in the fourth quarter.
At andyan din po si Sean Edifonso, who now has the basketball, looks inside to Aaron Fuller with six to shoot.
Immediately, Rain or Shine looks for Fuller.
That's a tough shot. And off the loose ball, matawagan ng...
Loose ball.
Loose ball foul, that's right, against John Makalalag. Umagal na talaga yung pace na nakita natin Coach Cholo. Late on Thursday night. It's almost 10 o'clock na dito sa Davao.
That's right.
So this will be a long night, lalo na sa mga nanonood dito sa USAP Gymnasium. But this is still a treat, because we have PBA teams now playing here in Davao City. 3 to shoot, Datu for 3. That's another miss. Datu struggling from the 3-point line. And here comes Lian Ramiro. Kasama niya si Phillips, Kiambao, Makalalag, and Austria. 13 to shoot for Ramiro. Launches for 3. Another miss.
Oh,
nice tap out by Michael Phillips. No look pass, and Phillips could not catch the basketball. At ayun na, nagbabalik na si Bo Belga, one of the crowd favorites from Rain or Shine. And also for La Salle, Abadam babalik din sa ball game as John Makalalag returns to the bench, playing some good minutes sa kanyang first game with La Salle. 8.5 minutes to go sa ating fourth quarter. Caracut able to break through the defense of Ramiro as Ramiro commits the foul. And that's the fourth team foul for the La Salle Green Archers. So they have to be careful with those fouls kasi they only have one foul to give with 8:27 in the fourth. Tapos isa lang yung team foul dito ng Rain or Shine as Caracut gets away. Another foul for La Salle. And that's the last foul to give for the De La Salle Green Archers with 8:20 remaining in the fourth.
That's an interesting play. Next foul would be in the penalty situation, right?
Exactly.
For Rain or Shine.
So two shots coming up for the former Lasallian, Andre Caracut. And the first shot is good for Andre.
Good stroke.
That's right. So having an illustrious career with the De La Salle Green Archers sa UAAP. Before he got drafted in the PBA, mitis nga lang yung pangalawang free throw for Andre. Still a one-point game as La Salle with a precarious one-point lead. Abadam goes to CJ Austria. Plenty of time in the shot clock. Balik ang Abadam para sa tres. Yes! Big three for EJ Abadam. Balik sa apat ang kambante ng De La Salle. Andre Caracut, may tanga ng bola. Bibigay ng pick si Bo Belga. Belga, inside pass to Fuller!
That is good. Yes, sir.
That counts and a foul.
That is the patented high-low play.
Oh, and a great recognition from that guy right there, Bo Belga.
Excellent passer.
And there's that last replay. Hatid sa inyo ng Arcadia Active Lifestyle Center. Look at that bullet pass from Bo Belga. And a great finish for Aaron Fuller. Tapos nga lang, but Fuller gets the offensive rebound off the miss. Now here comes Shawl in Defonso. Bo Belga with 7 to shoot. Now against KQ. Santi. And he stepped out of bounds. That's a turnover for Santi Santillan. But still, coach, dalawa pa rin ang habulin ng Rain or Shine. Very close battle.
Yes.
In the second half.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of moments na nagpalitan ng kalamangan ang dalawang koponan.
Grabe itong galasal, ano?
Oo. Free throw line jumper for Michael Phillips.
Wow.
Balik sa two possessions ang kalamangan ng De La Salle. 7 minutes 15 seconds remaining sa ating fourth and final quarter. Santillan on the roll! He missed the dunk! And here comes La Salle on the run on the other end.
Napakamot si Coach Yeng.
Ramiro open three! Well, blown the house down.
True.
But here comes Rain or Shine. Sa Bo Belga. Sa makabawi in this fourth quarter. Extra pass to Sean Ildefonso. Sa Bo Belga apologizing to Coach Yang Giao. At babalik muna si Mason Amos as Michael Phillips returns to the bench. So it's 93-89 for the De La Salle Green Archers. Kung di ako nagkakamali, Coach Solon, I believe that's the largest lead of the fourth quarter for La Salle.
I think so.
So that's how close the game is right now sa ating fourth quarter. Mukhang maging totoo yung sasabihin mo, Coach, na baka aabot to ng overtime. Who knows? We'll see.
True.
Plenty of basketball.
That's right.
Giambao down the baseline. Wow. What a tough shot. What a good contest from Bo Belga.
Mamu's back in.
Ito na, tumatakbo na si Mamuyak ng Rain or Shine. At natawagan ng foul. At penalty na ang De La Salle.
I think this is a good adjustment from Coach Yang, no? Kasi kanina, when Mamuyak was there, Santillan was there, I think this was the lineup na lumamang sila, no, kanina.
Oo.
Mm-hmm. So, I will not be surprised if they will catch up immediately after this, about two.
Especially with this lineup.
Yeah.
Oo, ng Rain or Shine.
The next 2 minutes would be crucial for Rain or Shine.
Exactly. Kasi tatlo pa rin ang habulin, but still has one more free throw for Aaron Fuller. And at this rate, he might be at the 30-point mark at the end of this one. Goes 2-for-2. So it's 93-91 in favor of the De La Salle Green Archers. Mm-hmm. So the defending UAP champion still has the lead. De La Salle looking for the quick answer. Amos, floater is good.
Grabe, no? From a big guy. Floater.
He's 6'7", but he has the moves of a guard.
Yeah. Mahirap yun.
Pero swabe yung mga tira doon na pinakita ni Amos. Santillan. In and out on the three. Fuller is there. But it's nga lang. Another chance. Another miss.
So miss.
Pero Karakot, with another offensive rebound. Balik ang Karakot to Fuller. Fall away. And that's a miss. And we have a battle underneath and a foul. That could be against Abadam. Hindi ako nakakamali. Let's see. It is a personal foul against EJ Abadam.
And now they have to take advantage with this penalty situation. They have to sink in free throws.
Oh.
This time for about the next five minutes.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So that's Santi Santillan making the first free throw. So second shot coming up for Leonard Santillan.
Oh,
hintis nga lang pero looks like we have a violation.
One more free throw for Santi.
Medyo matras si Santi, kaya nagmintis siya.
So shooting 66% from the free throw line in the previous conference, sa Philippine Cup.
He has to remain balanced, no?
Oo.
Eh no, umatras eh. Kita mo yung body language.
But somehow gets a friendly goal. Yes. So goes perfect this time. Still a two-point game, but La Salle still has the lead. And Kiambao and the rest of the squad of LaSalle.
Oh, yun.
Teka lang.
Just a regular foul.
So another whistle from our referees.
Fouls in jersey number 25, Santi Santillan.
And that's against Santi Santillan with a personal foul.
Foul on Santi.
So second personal foul for Santi.
Second e-foul for the last Lasapaters.
5:27 remaining sa ating fourth quarter.
Just a two-point lead.
And plenty of basketball remaining.
Right.
Abadam sneaks inside. And a blocking foul called against Rain or Shine.
Referee says, no, no, no. Blocking foul.
And that's against Andre Karakut. Pangilang foul na si Andre. Ika-apat na ang personal foul for Andre Karakut.
Two free throws for EJ Abadam.
So two shots coming up for EJ Abadam. Tulad yung sinabi ko kanina, Coach Jolo, the crowd is really anticipating that this could be a race to the finish line, a tight battle. Lalo na at crunch time.
You could see, you could feel anxious yung mga ano, yung mga tao, no.
Mm-hmm. It's now a one possession game still.
Good LaSalle. Good kick out.
Santillan. Oh. Medyo mabilis yung release niya yung kanyang outside shot. And here comes LaSalle. Looking to protect their lead as they're up by 3 points. Abadam. Almost a steal by Mamu. He's trying to dive into the court side.
Sumuntok sa air eh.
Akala niya
nangyayang siya, no?
Nanginayang siya na buti niyang maagawan yung bola.
Yes, yes.
Now here comes Amos. Phillips hesitates. Now has to look for an open teammate. 5 to shoot. Phillips in trouble. Gives it up to Amos with 2.
Uh-oh.
And a foul against Mason Amos. Shot will not count. And you can hear the voice of Coach Yang Gao as he's trying to talk to one of the referees. So fourth personal foul for Bo Belga as Coach Yang Gao seeking an explanation from referee Brian Peclaro. So we're under 5 minutes remaining sa ating fourth quarter. At matawagan ng warning si Bo Belga. At tatawag muna ng timeout ang De La Salle Green Archers. Green Archers, the defending UAAP champions, looking to protect their lead against the PBA squad, Rain or Shine, Elasto Painters. So here comes EJ Abadam. Golena off the curl. Amos now against Bo Belga. Ito, magandang labanan dito between these two forwards. Amos has to kick it out. Dungo at the buzzer. And a quick rebound by Aaron Fuller. Kasama niya si Andre Karakut, Bo Belga, Gian Mamuyak, and Leonard Satnilian. That's the 5 on the floor for Coach Yang Giao. Fuller. Back to Karakut. And draws the foul. So two shots coming up for Andre Karakut.
Again, they had to take advantage in the free throw line.
Falls in jersey number 32. Third personal foul.
And that's the third personal foul for Goliena.
For Andre Karakut.
Yeah, they're still down by 4. With 4 minutes remaining in this ballgame.
Kung di ako nagkakamali, Coach Cholo, mukhang di pa natikman yung kalamangan ang Rain or Shine so far in the fourth quarter.
That's right, no? They have been trailing all throughout the fourth quarter.
Looks like the closest deficit they have reached is probably 2 points.
Yes,
yeah. Tama ka dyan, Coach Cholo.
Mm. Down to a two-point lead once again. Again, crucial stop here for Rain or Shine.
Now here comes Michael Phillips. As Rain or Shine looking for that crucial stop. Abadam inside to Michael Phillips. With 8 to shoot. Goliena. Kontra kang Bo Belga. Abadam, top shot! And another rebound for Michael Phillips. Babangga, kontra kang Aaron Fuller. Nice hook shot for Michael Phillips.
They shouldn't allow that offensive rebound. The second chance points are killing them right now. So, wow. Beautiful move.
That was a slashing move. Balakang Gian Mamuyak as he'll go to the line for 2 shots. ang bilis na, no? Yung pagbaba sa bola ni Gian Mamuyak.
The explosion from Gian.
So two shots coming up for Gian Mamuyak. And there's that replay hatid sa inyo ng the Royal Mandaya Hotel. Nice hook shot for the big man, Michael Phillips.
Good touch, right? Mahirap touch. Yun. Mahirap kontrolin yun. Nasa, nasa malapit lang ng, ano, eh, ng ring.
Mm-hmm. Tapos you have that long wingspan na nakita natin from Michael Phillips. Mm-hmm. Standing 6'8".
Wow, 6'8".
And makes the second free throw. Still a two-point game. And we have another whistle.
Ako po.
Anong nangyari doon na Cusciolo?
Eh, nagmadali si Amos eh.
Oh, that's a costly turnover. That's right. And that's a costly turnover indeed for LaSalle. So a chance for Rain or Shine to tie or take a lead with a three-point shot. Belga, extra pass. Mamu, attacking baseline. Counted and one. And just like that, Coach Cholo, we're tied at 99.
Familiar. I've seen this game.
Oo nga, no?
Nangangamoy.
Mukha nga. And there's that replay atin sa inyo ng Genesis 88 Construction. Look at that. Quick move by Gian Mamuyak, the former Ateneo Blue Eagle, with a chance for the three-point play.
The explosiveness of this guy. Very young.
Oo. But very fast. Standing 6'2". So a chance for the three-point play for Mamu.
Oh, yes.
And a lead for the Rain or Shine Alaska Painters, 100-99. Still plenty of basketball remaining. 3.5 minutes to go.
So we talked about it earlier, no? The next 2 to 3 minutes for Rain or Shine was crucial. Here you go. They're leading now. So they've adjusted.
Jambal for three. Got it!
Oh! Bumawi.
Nakabawi si KQ. Kila sa stalwart gives LaSalle a 2-point lead, 102-100. Looks inside to Aaron Fuller. And a steal by De La Salle. LaSalle goes on the run. Extra pass, Phillips. But makalalag will try.
No!
And that's Andre Caraco tracks it down. Mamuyas, no! Fuller! Draws the foul. Two shots coming up for Aaron Fuller. Oh, yun na. Bububuhay na ang USEP crowd.
Yeah. Fuller was trying to finish off with his left hand.
Oh.
But unfortunately, didn't.
So, Aaron Fuller looking to drill the first. Nako. Intis yung una. Still has one more though.
Sorry miss for Fuller. One more chance to redeem himself.
Exactly.
With 2 minutes and 40 remaining. Again, malayo pa.
Malayo pa. Bilog pa ang bola pa rin. The final 2:40 sa ating fourth quarter. And that shot goes for Aaron Fuller. 1-point game. 102-101. This is crunch time sa ating first day of the Kadayawan Invitational Basketball Tournament 2024.
The Green Archers, shot clock 18 seconds.
So Green Archers pa rin ang bola. So here comes Abadam with the inbounds pass. Looks to Phillips. Knocked away by Aaron Fuller with 18 on the shot clock.
Green Archers, 18 seconds on the shot clock.
So this has been the battle on the among the front court players ng Rain or Shine at ng LaSalle. Now here comes Abadam. Off the pick. And that was a missed shot.
Foul on Phillips, I guess.
I think so.
Yeah.
Pangilang foul na si Michael Phillips. Diyan natin.
But the thing is, they're on penalty.
So penalty na talaga ang LaSalle.
Oh,
that's his sixth and final foul for Michael Phillips. So that ends his evening for the De La Salle Green Archers for their first game sa ating Invitational Basketball Tournament.
Binigyan ng medal eh. Si Michael Phillips.
Ayun.
ano na batang to. Kinokongratulate pa. Binigyan ng medal. Towel nga lang. Ano? Kakatawa yung mga bata. They're just enjoying the experience here.
So it has been an entertaining experience for all of us.
Yes.
In Davao City.
That is true.
So, but this time around for LaSalle, they're gonna play without Michael Phillips for the next 2:25 sa ating fourth quarter. As for that misses the second, pero nevertheless, we are tied at 102. Crucial possession for LaSalle.
Yan na nga sinasabi natin eh. Ay, nako po.
But a foul call against Aaron Fuller as Kiambao draws a foul on a three-point attempt.
Fouls in jersey number 9, Aaron Fuller.
Nangangamoy overtime.
Oh my.
Three free throws.
This is a repeat, huh? Possibly.
Could be. Tingnan natin. KQ with three free throws.
Three free throws indeed for Kevin Kiambao. The defending finals MVP and the season MVP of the UAP hits the first free throw. So Kevin Kiambao trying to stay perfect at the foul line on his trip. He averaged about 14.7 points and 9 rebounds. Hits the second. Much to the delight of the De La Salle bench. So great averages for Kevin Kiambao during the UAAP Finals against the UP Fighting Maroons. Averages of 14 points, 9 rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 blocks per game on the 3-game final series. So it was an epic finals matchup last year for LaSalle as they went on to win the title sa UAAP. Okay, one more shot coming up for Kevin Kiambao. Goes perfect from the foul line, 3 of 3.
The LaSalle bench powered that the last free throw for KQ.
Uh-oh, Baga in trouble, but Karakot able to break through the defense. Now Karakot taking his time with 12 to shoot. Under 2 minutes remaining sa ating final game of day 1 of the International Basketball Tournament. Foul for the loose ball and Kiambao has it. Now Kiambao looking for the knockout blow against Rainer Shine.
This could be a backbreaker right here.
Pablo, babalik ang KQ for 3.
Oh, short.
And loose ball out of bounds. And that will go to Rainer Shine. And we're under 100 seconds remaining sa ating fourth and final quarter. And the defending UAP champions looking to make a statement against the Rain or Shine Elasto Painters of the PBA.
Injured yata to si KQ.
So we hope nothing is serious for Kevin Kiambao. He looks alright. Still on the basketball floor. At nasa kamay ngayon ni Andre Karakot. Ibigay ng pick si Aaron Fuller. Karakot looks for the opening. Gets inside and the layup.
Very patient play for Karakot.
Down to a 1-point game. 105 to 104.
No need to be in a rush here for De La Salle. KQ now.
And for De La Salle, they're looking for the clutch basket. Mm-hmm. With a minute remaining sa ating fourth quarter. Kiambao, tough three. Mintis nga lang, and Belga secures the rebound. And here comes Rainer Shine.
Winning time.
That's right, Rainer Shine looking for the big shot to take the lead in the fourth. Karakot now has it to score the last basket. For Rainer Shine. Karakot looks to Belga. Inside to Fuller. Inside for two. 1-point lead for Rainer Shine. Timeout De La Salle. Big play for the Rainer Shine Elasto Painters.
Big play from the big guy.
And look at this replay at isa yun ng Bullet International Logistics Incorporated. Great court vision for Bo Belga, able to spot the cutting Aaron Fuller for two. 42 and a half seconds remaining sa ating fourth quarter. So Coach Cholo, this is a reminder that this is just like the first game kanina.
Exactly. So Big Bo has been very effective in the high post.
Oh.
And entry passes, no? Throwing entry passes to Fuller.
At saka yung veteran experience ni Bo Belga, yeah, binibigay dito ng Rainer Shine,
right,
against the defending UAP champions.
You cannot leave Bo as well. He would take that shot.
No. Oh.
Gladly take that three-point shot. But
exactly.
Backdoor pull game with 42 seconds on the game clock.
42 seconds remaining sa ating fourth and final quarter. So we're checking at the timeout situation. Tatlo po yung naiwan timeout for Rain or Shine. Samantalang LaSalle only has one timeout remaining. No more fouls to give for both teams. Penalty na ang LaSalle Green Archers. And for Rain or Shine has five team fouls, so they have to be careful. So they don't want to commit another unnecessary foul in the final 42 seconds of this game. Here comes Kiambao. Kasama niya si Makalalag, Amos, Goliena, and Abadam. That's the five on the floor for LaSalle. Here we go. And this time around, winning time for LaSalle. Amos, balikan Goliena. Gets to the rim. No! And Santillan secures the rebound.
Sort of miss.
And for Rain or Shine, they're looking for the dagger shot.
3 second differential from the shot clock and game clock.
Nine to shoot for Gian Mamuyak against Abadam. And there's a pick by Aaron Fuller. There's a switch guarded by Amos. Mamu, fall away. No.
Uh-oh.
4 seconds. Kiambao stripped by Clarito. Clarito with the big steal. And Rain or Shine takes a 106-105 win over the defending UAP champions, the De La Salle Green Archers. What a game, Coach Cholo.
Yes, Rain or Shine escaped this game, you know. But again, hats off to De La Salle University for a great job, excellent job.
Thank you for watching. Kung nagustuhan mo ang video na ito ay mag-subscribe ka na sa ating channel. Paki-follow na rin ang ating Facebook page, Utak Pilipinas. Again, this is D Sports TV. Paalam.